Chuck, illustrated by Bill Thompson. Once upon a time, there were three kids named Lily, Claire, and Lucas trotting down a wet sidewalk. They were going to a park in Weston on a gloomy, rainy day on May 21st, 2028. Lucas found an awkward bag with stars on the ground, under a tree. He picked it up. "What's in there?" Lily asked. Then, kind of scared, Claire looked in it, very curious to see what was there. It was Chuck. Claire decided to pick a color out of the bag. "I'm gonna draw something," Claire says. She brought her hand out of the bag and found a yellow piece of chalk sitting in her hand. She then sat on the wet ground and started to draw a sun. Right when she finished drawing her sun, a very bright and circular thing appeared in the sky. When the children looked up, the rain was stopping and the sunshine was coming out. "Wow," all the children say. When the children looked up, the rain was stopping and the sunshine was coming out. It was like they were God, where they got to choose the weather. They were thrilled. Then Lily takes off her raincoat, puts her hand in the bag that Lucas found, and pulled out an orange piece of chalk. Then she began drawing butterflies. Then all of the butterflies she drew came to life as well. "I bet you whatever we draw comes to life. Since Claire drew the sun, it became a sunny day. And since Lily drew butterflies, they are coming to life," Lucas said. "Oh yeah, he's right," Claire exclaimed. Then, Lucas pulls a piece of chalk out of the bag and gets a green piece. He decides to start drawing a dinosaur. "What if I draw a dinosaur and that comes to life too? That would be awesome, especially if we can control it. Something big, green, and fierce was growing up to the sky. It looked like it was growing to heaven, and it finally stopped growing. It was the dinosaur. "Oh no, it's coming to life," Lily screamed. The dinosaur was chasing them, and I think he wants lunch. "Run," Claire exclaimed, but then she found out Lucas and Lily were already running. They ran their hearts out until they reached the play area, and they jumped up on the equipment and slid down the slide to hide. The dinosaur was running around looking for the children. "Do you think he sees us?" Lily yelled so Claire and Lucas could hear her. "I don't think he can. It seems like he's looking for us," Lucas said. Then the dinosaur bends down farther than his body will go and looks in the slide. "There are the children," Lily and Lucas said together. "I've got an idea," Lucas said, pulling out a piece of chalk. He started drawing before Lily could ask what his idea was. Then he started drawing a rain cloud. All of a sudden, dark clouds start covering up the bright sun, and the kids can feel little raindrops dropping from the clouds. Then the dinosaur starts to vanish. The kids realize that since the dinosaur was made of chalk, the rain would wash away. But how did the rain start? "Get it. If it was sunny, wouldn't it be sunny until we draw another rain cloud?" Claire questioned. "I drew the rain cloud," Lucas said. "I thought if I drew rain, then the dinosaur would get washed away." "That was really clever of you," Lily says, and the children start walking down the again wet sidewalk. They did not believe what had happened today. But they knew no one was going to believe what they had to say.